Alan Johnson's road to the final. You know what's at stake for him. Trying to win at the mountain for the seventh time in the last 9 years. Waiting for him, Larry Morgan. The last time he won multiple races, Mike Dunn, in a single season, 25 years ago. Denver was one of those four wins that he had that year.
Got a good chance to do it again here, because just like in Pro Stock Motorcycles, your number one, number two qualifier, we talk about the domination with Alan Johnson up here on the mountain. Larry Morgan, though, has been running very well, been running the numbers right there with him. And Larry taking out Erica in the semifinals, that was a big race for him.
Can the FireAide driver douse the king of the mountain? We're about to find out. Nobody in any hurry here to get into the stage beams. Look at the duel, now over 23, 24, 25 seconds.
Both these guys are pretty stubborn.
Mark Lyle, he says, go at it, boys. Just remember the epic one between Warren Johnson and Dave Conley. WJ ended up calling him a punk, but these are two veterans. And this is getting interesting. 45 seconds now.
How about the Mets, Dave?
Yeah, sounds like they did pretty well today. Your Yanks won as well. We got all kinds of time to talk about the other things that are going on.
And the Dodgers, man, what happened to them?
Mark Lyle digging his heels in. At what point does he step up and say, all right, boys, enough is enough. Let's settle this. Now approaching a minute 15. Fans are going crazy. Roy likes it. Boy, do what you gotta do. You know Larry Morgan's gonna be like, I'm good.
Yeah, I don't know, like I said, they're both pretty stubborn. It'll be interesting to see who goes in first.
Now over a minute 30.
There goes
Alan. Finally, Alan's in. Morgan has 7 seconds to go in. Takes almost all of that, and we're away.
Oh, and Morgan gets the advantage.
Look out, did the king of the mountain just get knocked off his top? Yes, he did!
Oh, man.
Larry Morgan on a hole shot.
Oh, man, was that classic or what?
That had everything going for it. And look at Diane back at the starting line, his wife. You know, the beginning of this year, we talked about Larry Morgan getting the new horsepower, getting the new manufacturer Chevrolet involved. It reinvigorated him, and that is going to be one happy man that pops out of that car in a moment.
I can't wait for this interview, because that was classic Pro Stock. I love it. The staging deal, we've seen a number of these over the years, including the late Scott Jeffrion and Warren Johnson. They had some classic battles.
Watch your move
staging
first.
Duels, but Alan went in first. Larry Morgan, as soon as he put in, great reaction time. 0-14 off of the tree. Alan was 35, had 2/3 of a second right there. And the way Larry had been running, he figured he was probably going to get the win, and he was able to do it.
2 weeks ago in Chicago, Alan Johnson beat Larry Morgan for the Wally, their only prior final round matchup. And now 2 weeks later, Larry Morgan has repaid that debt and knocked the king of the mountain off the summit.
With Larry's wife, Diane. And Diane, you realize it's been 25 years since Larry's won multiple races in a season. What's this mean to you guys?
Thanks. That means we're really kind of old and being out here a long time, but we're just so excited about this. We're probably the happiest people in Pro Stock right now, and can't thank our sponsors, FireAide, Ron Thames, Ron and Teresa, and the Grays. Love them like family. We are just having a ball.
They are getting ready to party. Let's go down to where the party's starting with Gary Gerald.
I don't even know where to start. Tell us about that burn down right there at the starting line, Larry Morgan.
You know, Al and I both come up here and tested, and we were running back and forth, and I'm telling you, he's owned this hill. He's done a fine job up here. You know what? Nobody will ever do what he's done here. And to come up here and beat him, you know, we're just so blessed to be here. You know, FireAide, Lucas Oil, Streamlight, all the good people that helped me. And I got to really thank Johnny Gray. I mean, without that guy, I wouldn't be here. And Justin Nelks is the crew chief on our car, and my son Nick, and those guys all work together, and all the guys at Gray's, you know, without those guys, you know, I don't even know how we could even do this.
When you went to the line, did you have in your mind it was going to be a staging duel, or did it just happen?
Well, I kind of feared it, because him and I had been having those lately, and I thought, you know what, I'm just not going to go in there. So when it all started to happen, I got on my radio and I said to my guys, I go, I guess he just doesn't want to stage, does he? But it was good. I'm just so happy to be here. Mellow Yellow, NHRA, all the good people's behind this. We're just so happy to be here. And hey, I won a Mopar race. in a Chevy. I've won two Mopar races, and they were both in GM cars. And when I raced for Mopar, I only got runner-up, so that was good. Real good for all of us.
Congratulations.
Thank you.